So let's look at the solution to our mesh versus bus throughput quiz, where we had four cores with a totally random and even distribution of traffic among the cores. We are given what each core is sending. We are getting what the bus can do and what the link in a mesh can do. And now we are asked, how much faster is it on the bus versus on the mesh? Our bus cannot sustain the 40 million messages per second that the cores are trying to give it. So the cores are really gonna slow down to half of their speed so that the bus bandwidth demand matches what it can provide. So on the bus, we get 2x the execution time that each core is capable of providing. On the mesh, we can support 20 million messages per second per link. So now the question is, do our links get saturated? So let's see what we get on a mesh like this in terms of traffic. Each core is generating 10 million messages. 3.3 million are going to each other core. So of the 10 million messages sent here, 1/3 are going to this core. 1/3 are going through this link, and then 1/3 are going here. Let's say that 1/6 go this way, 1/6 go this way. So this link will be used for 1/6 of the messages sent by this core, and this one for another 1/6. And then we add 1/6 to each of these, which brings us to 1/2 of 10 million messages. So now we are done with this core. What happens from this core? Same thing. This link gets 1/2 of the messages. 1/3 are going here, 1/6 are going here. So this link suffers 1/2 of this traffic again. Now this link gets 1/2 of the traffic from this core, and these two links get 1/6 each. And now we're done with this core. Now what happens when this core is sending? 1/2 of the messages go this way, 1/2 go this way. 1/6 of them go through this link, and 1/6 go through this link. Done with this core, and finally this core sends messages half here, half here, and then 1/6 here, and 1/6 here. Now we're done with this core. So as you can see, our links are actually evenly used. Each of them gets 2 × 1/2 plus 2/6. So we get 1 1/3 times the traffic generated by one core. That was what the 1/2 was off. The traffic from one core is 10 million messages a second. So we're really getting 10 plus 3.3. So this is 13.3 million of messages per second, which is available on our mesh. So the mesh doesn't slow down the processors. So really the speed up of using the mesh versus the bus is 2, because the bus requires the cores to slow down so that it can support the traffic that they're generating, while the mesh allows the cores to proceed at full speed at 10 million messages per second and still has some traffic left over. If we went to a larger network than 4 cores, the bus would have to proportionally slow down, while the mesh would get more links, and it will be a while until any of the mesh links becomes saturated. So clearly, the mesh is far superior to the bus in terms of the traffic it can support when we go to more cores.